Hello there guys, Feng here, and welcome to more of a channel update than anything else, but we're going to be talking a little bit about Playerunknown's Battlegrounds. So, the game is a battle royale game. It's the same devs who did the battle royale mod for Armor 3. I unfortunately never really got a chance to play that particular mod. Don't really get a chance to play much Armor 3 these days, mainly just due to the fact that my computer doesn't really run it very well. You know, it's getting on with the times now, I think. That's kind of what this video is going to be about. But the game's in closed beta. It's available only during the weekend, so it's got kind of a bit of a time frame. I just wanted to get some footage out. It's not the best, so I do apologize for that. I especially apologize for the graphic fidelity. You know, this video doesn't do it justice, and I was thinking about not doing it at all, but I do want to try and get something out and let you know what's going on. So yeah, so with that in mind, when I actually loaded the game up, I noticed the one thing that really got me worried was the fact that the FPS was not up to par for my liking. It was between 20 and 30 with the settings on medium, and I'm like, something doesn't seem right there. I put the graphics down to very low, and I got a bit of a FPS game, but not much. And my first instinct was like, well, maybe the game is not optimized yet. That's partially true. The game isn't particularly optimized yet, but even so, I should be getting more frames than what I thought I was getting, you know, what I was getting. So I decided to do a few tests. I tested this game. I tested H1Z1, Battlefield 1, The Division, and 7 Days to Die. I wanted to, you know, test a different variety of games that were both graphically intensive and CPU intensive, and see what the fuck was going on. So with all my monitors there, my GPU monitor, my CPU monitor, my RAM monitor, and all the other stuff, I was looking to see what the hell was going on. So the major thing that I noticed straight from the get-go was that when I was just playing these games, was my GPU was hitting between 95 and 100% on every game, and I was like, oh god, okay, that's probably where the problem is. So either my GPU's fucked, or it's just the fact that it might just be too old now. I'm using the 7970 3GB, which, you know, I've had for 5-6 years now. Back in the day when I got it, it was one of the best AMD cards you could get. But compared to a lot of the cards these days, it is so inferior to majority of the more up-to-date cards. So after realizing that, I thought, well, that's probably one of the main reasons why a lot of the content that I've been doing on the channel recently with these graphic intensive games have had really bad frame losses. And, you know, I do apologize for that. I didn't really realize until I did these tests that it was the GPU that was causing this. So I'm actually going to go ahead and splurge out on a new graphics card. So I've been shopping around, been looking around, and been comparing all the cards. I was thinking about getting a new AMD card, but I actually kind of fought against it. Instead, I'm going to grab the GTX 1070 8GB overclocked edition. There's actually two main reasons for this. So the main reason was that it's at a decent price, and it's a pretty damn good card. It's a really good card. I was thinking maybe the 1060, since it was a bit cheaper. It wasn't much cheaper, but it was a bit cheaper, and there wasn't too much difference in regards to specs. But the problem with the 1060 is that it's not Sly compatible. So yeah, that was a bit unfortunate. So I thought I'd grab myself the 1070, and at least if I do need to upgrade any other part of my system, then, you know, it's kind of more future-proof in that regard, so as I can actually Sly on better. But the second reason as well is Shadowplay. So The problem with Bandicam sometimes is that it does 8 frames while it's recording. It hasn't really been doing that for a lot of games. It's only been doing it for games that are quite graphic intensive. Because what happens is Bandicam uses some of the GPU power to record. Bearing in mind, my GPU was at 95% to 100% in use before it was even recording. So when I actually hit that bloody record button on some of these games, while that was at 100%, the CPU usage was just off the charts because of it. Because it has to draw the power from somewhere if it's not using the graphics. So not only is it a hell of a lot bigger memory-wise, I mean it's 8GB compared to 3, but Shadowplay is supposed to be pretty good at video capturing as well, so I'll probably end up playing with that and just see what's best. I mean, I'd rather keep with Bandicam if I can, but there's a very good chance I might just switch to Shadowplay if it's better than it. So that's another reason why I really wanted to get that particular card instead of an AMD card. Alrighty then, so hopefully, I do mean this, hopefully once I got it installed and, you know, done all the drivers and whatnot, I'll do some more Battlegrounds coverage. Again, I apologise that this isn't as graphically, you know, it's not really, it hasn't got much graphic fidelity. You know, it's just the way it is. I just wanted to get some content out with it, you know, just to show you guys what it's like. So I've been really enjoying it. Even with the frame drops, I have been enjoying the hell out of this game. The gunplay is fan-fucking-tastic. It reminds me a lot of Armor 3, which, again, I couldn't really enjoy as much because, you know, that game wasn't really optimized. Whereas, you know, this feels like it's got a hell of a lot of potential. It already feels better than H1Z1. A lot of the mechanics are a lot better. You've already got more gun variety, for one. That in itself is a huge plus, because H1Z1's gun variety is fucking bland as fuck. It really is. Not only that, you can also customize your guns. You can find parts for your guns, like red dot sights and 4x scopes and whatnot. And that's fantastic. And one of the things that I really can't wait to try out when it goes live is the hardcore mode. One of the really massive disappointments of H1Z1 is the fact that they got rid of the hardcore mode, and I never got a chance to play that because I would prefer playing in first person. It always feels like cheesing and cheating when you're playing third person, because you can sit around corners so much easier compared to first person. Whereas this game is going to have that hardcore mode with first person only and third person disabled. I cannot wait for that. That is probably going to be the mode I'm going to be playing the most of this game. And, you know, I'm just looking forward to it. I really am. Really am looking forward to it once it comes out. Okay then, guys. So I do believe that the game is going to be released on Steam Early Access for the 23rd of March. Not too sure the prices. I don't think they've actually announced a price yet for Steam Early Access. I have no clue, unfortunately. But I'll leave a link in the description below of the link for the Steam Early Access page and whatnot. Alright then, guys, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and leave you with the rest of the video. Again, I do apologise for the graphic fidelity. You'll understand why I've had to do it like this. And, you know, hopefully in the future videos we'll be able to see a lot more graphic goodness. Again, apologies. Right then, also at the end, there's a very, very slight chance I might be a bit blind. Very blind. Extremely blind. I need glasses blind. I'll see you next time. sake.